Ba-da-da-ba-ba-ba. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Team Spirit versus Virtus Pro. This is game number one of the best of five series here for the Betway Arena King of the Hill Showmatch Series. Remember, I forgot to plug it during the opening, but if you want to win that beautiful signed jersey up at the top left, it is an NIP jersey signed by the entire squad, including Mr. Sindarin. You could also get a Blade Form Legacy Arcana. For the layman's out there, that is the Juggernaut Arcana with the little dragon set brought to you by Team Spirit. Yeah. Support your team, folks. Support your team.
That's great. That's a lot. That's a lot of value, as they say.
There is a link below the Twitch stream, though. It's one of them Gleam links, gleam.io. Click on it. Love it. Live it. It could be you. Troll Warlord Magnus, first two heroes banned out, boys.
Yeah. And Trent, as you were saying, the IO ban for Virtus Pro against
it's Spirit, gone.
It's not there anymore. It is gone from the game. Remaining.
Yeah, and this Troll Warlord, I guess they're just done with Troll. They've been playing against it a lot lately, and VP's been playing it quite a bit, so let's just eliminate that.
Oh,
sorry, bud. At least the number one pick, Abaddon, is still in the pool, as well as Alchemist, who have been fiending it up at DAC together.
Good. I love Alchemist games.
I know you do.
I don't know if you're aware of that.
My favorite.
Trent.
I love Alchemist. Any experience
with my Alchemist, love. /hate.
So, just real quick, Bounty Team Hunter. Spirit. Okay, you know what? I was going to say they pick a lot of Slaughter, but you know what? They've already picked Bounty Hunter. So much for that.
Slaughter got a lot of hate lately, man. He's down in the dumps.
Is he really?
I don't know. Everyone's like back onto these other cool heroes. Like, I guess Bounty Hunter is one example. But
wait,
just,
is Abaddon a CIS hero at all, though?
Has I he think he's everyone hero now, dude.
Yeah, that's
has he
really
gotten
really
to
good.
CIS yet?
Well, I don't think so. You weren't wrong.
Maybe they're not aware, guys.
Well, here's the thing: Team Spirit hasn't picked it in like the past 20 games or so. So it's not something they go for, at least not often. But other CIS squads have been picking it up, like Vega, stuff like that. France have been picking it up, so
it
is slightly a
crazy
CIS squad, but not as much as you know.
It's crazy to think about IX Mike starting a trend. The entire world is
that's happened like two times, two or three times,
now.
Dude. Remember offline Omni Knight?
What else?
I fucking love IX Mike.
That's not bad. That's true.
Okay.
Offlane Omni, was every region doing that, though?
It was pretty popular.
That was NA, mostly.
Yeah, I guess you're right. But it's like him, Universe, and Bulba are the three trendsetters when it comes to offlane.
Yeah. Well, Slardar Darkseer, great combo. We've seen a number of times. He put the Ion Shell on the Slardar. He chases people down. He already does a lot of damage, so it's just a nice combo. Also, having Surge allows him to get in there, connect with some crushes. Overall, very synergistic combo. Very safe opener, and already some red versus blue action. As Team Spirit, they picked the Juggernaut, boys. Maybe, just maybe, they've got the Arcana to show off for us.
I would say it's likely.
Pretty nice pick here, right? You're up against Darkseer in lane. This really helps when you have a Bounty Hunter, too, because it frees him up to roam a lot, because you have a Juggernaut who's like so stable, so he doesn't need too much assistance in lane, so this Bounty's just like free to go wherever. And now we probably want at least a mid that can capitalize on his roams, and even an offlaner is kind of handy.
Yeah. So I think Jug against the Darkseer, pretty good laning combination if they want to go for that, but we'll see what they ban. I'm surprised the Underlord ban is starting to come out more often now. I think that hero is extraordinarily tanky, so difficult to take down in lane, in that off lane.
It's funny that after Atrophy Aura got nerfed, everyone was talking about how terrible Pit Lord is, and slowly but surely, he's on his way back.
Oh, he's back, man.
Pit of Malice, not going through BKB. It's useless!
Actually,
it turns out it's still a damn annoying spell in pretty much every situation.
It's really freaking good. So
I think it's better than it was, actually, the Pit of Malice.
The pit?
Yeah. It's
it does
sticky
root a
now,
lot.
It feels like.
Yeah. Like,
it's
if
just
you
his
Atrophy
got just dumped on.
There's like Disruptor and Underlord I've seen a couple times. It's just gross. Like, just like you're stuck in this kinetic field and then this pit comes down. Or even if you have just like a CM or something and you're stuck in it and you get rooted and you can't go out. And there she is, by the way. I thought she was going to be a top pick up for both these teams coming the second phase. Because we talk about like Darkseer needing all that mana now because of the nerf. And then CM's really good against Darkseer in lane too. So Juggernaut CM is like the ideal two heroes. Not going to worry about the pressure you guys throw at us. Like she can Frostbite the Iron Shell if it's on a creep. Or she can Frostbite an Iron Shell running in Slardar. So
what happened to Centaur?
I mean, he's still picked occasionally. It's just not as much as he was, I guess. He was like first picked a lot past couple of weeks, but recently, like, the trend's been slowing down. They're going for other things. Not to say that it's not picked up ever, but
nerf was the 60-40% for Ags, I believe.
Well, I mean, Sunset, it must have been the nerf. Now the Aghanims is just terrible.
I mean, it's still good, but
I think if it was dropped to 30%, then I don't think you buy Ags on that hero anymore.
Oh, what is this?
Spirit Breaker.
What?
Whoa.
What? What?
All right, hold up. What is going on here?
Isn't this the DK Phobos hero? Trent?
Phobos. Oh, yes. Yeah, the Shaker is. I'm more concerned about the fact they have Spear Picker, Slider, and Darkseer. This is exciting.
This is getting interesting.
So who
is this a position one Slardar?
It very well could
is it back?
Be?
So
ladies
it could
and gentlemen?
Be safe lane Slardar with some kind of an aggro try. Remaining. Absolutely.
Right.
Is there any merit to a mid Darkseer?
I mean, that's what I was thinking, but I don't know. I mean, that's like maybe.
We've seen it like extremely rarely, yeah. But I feel like they must have some crazy tower pusher coming out last, yeah. And they're just going to try and like run at them.
I mean, Spirit Breaker Darkseer is also pretty amazing. Same concept with the Slardar. You put the Ion Shell on him, lets the old cow chase him down.
I almost feel like a Lina would be really good for VP. But I don't know if that's a no-one hero.
I think he's played it before. He played it a couple patches back, I'm pretty sure. I want to say that he did, but I might be wrong.
This is pretty cool, though. I like this.
It really is. Yeah.
I want to see this core shaker go to work. That's one of my favorite heroes to watch as core. One of my least favorite to watch as support.
Yeah, I
agree
with
you.
It's
so boring.
I think
he has
like what was it? Wings picked it last night as support, and they just got dumped on. It's just useless the whole game.
It just doesn't come online.
They pick it a lot on Team Spirit though, and for DK Phobos, as you said. But even sometimes they'll give it to FNG, and it really is like night and day what the hero can do. Like it's so difficult to be that Slardar and get the early blink dagger as position four on Shaker, because you look at Fisher, 15-second cooldown. You get one, you know.
I mean,
that's your only spell to help.
We go back
team
to this point
to
with Crystal Maiden a lot, but Earthshaker, one of the quintessential heroes that gets benefit out of the Brilliant Sora. I mean, it changes his lane presence because it's not just about Fissure when you're playing Core Shaker. It's all about spamming the totem and having.
Was that a Han term that I just heard?
No, that was Warcraft.
Brilliant
3
Sora.
Term.
That is Warcraft 3. You heathen.
All right, sorry. Yeah. I mean, usually you're a Han guy. I'm sorry.
Step your game up,
you
Trent.
Animal.
Let's find the Han term real quick. BRB.
All right, well, see you later, Shannon.
What was his name?
Behemoth.
That Glacius.
That was his Earthshaker's name in Han.
Uh-huh.
Behemoth.
Behemoth?
There was also an item called Behemoth Heart.
I got to say, that's
the lore was unbelievable.
No
Glacius.
The
Glacius.
The passive was Chilling Presence.
He wasn't Spanish. It's not Glacius.
And the cool thing is you can imprison yourself, Trent.
Ah, sorry. Yes,
you could also
you can frostbite
yourself in that game,
and it was like Winter Wyvern.
Tom,
you frostbite yourself, and you become you just take less damage. It's not like Wyvern.
Oh,
you take like 50% less damage or something.
Yeah.
Well,
amazing mechanics, uncanny.
I gotta say, Behemoth is a pretty freaking good name.
Behemoth.
It sounds intense, doesn't it?
Oh, hell yeah, dude. I forget what his alt was called, but it was some badass like...
Oh, I can find out for it if you'd like.
Get us the info, Shannon.
Echo of the Ages. You have the internet?
Tell us
more.
Yes. Oh, wow.
It was called Shockwave, actually.
Okay, that's kind of a dumb name. Magnus's regular spell is Shockwave. That was his ultimate. What a pussy.
Guess what Fissure was called?
What?
Fissure.
Oh! Who would have thought?
Wow.
I think this last pick is very difficult for Team Spirit.
I mean, this is a hard final ban here.
Because,
you can tell they're
yeah.
thinking about it.
Because they love, what do they love? Tinker, Ember will be two heroes they love, but you're up against Spirit Breaker and Slardar and Disruptor. So any of those slippery heroes that benefit so much from maneuverability are very dangerous here. So like, I think a Shadow Fiend's probably the best pick.
Man, what a god.
You're so good.
You know
dude.
Me.
Okay. Well, a lot of carry power now for Team Spirit. Very nice to have the Bounty Hunter.
You can pick literally anything mid and it should do fine, right?
Well, I think because you're Radiant side, so you can benefit. There's still Alchemist,
Lina,
which
I
could see just being the pick here.
But you said Lina
like,
as well.
Why
I think Lina's still
Alk.
Pretty good here also. If you
yeah,
go
Lina's
for,
still
for
okay.
No
who wins the matchup, Shadow Fiend Lina?
I think it's one of those, like, because you get a lot of help mid, because Lina's attack animation's god-awful in the first couple levels, right? So you, like,
garbage.
Have to spell, but...
Yeah. But she
they'll
has
probably
the
like run Slardar mid or something.
Her attack animation's terrible, but she can still harass the Shadow Fiend and last hit with spells, and you can sort of zone him. But I'm not sure. Yeah. Like once you hit level 3, level 4, Shadow Fiend might be able to kind of bully the.
It's
lane.
Just that super important who wins. It's not so much a matchup thing as like who's gonna help who and like who just wins that first either couple creeps for Shadow Fiend, right, and he gets that advantage position, or Lina just like gets one assistance and she just LSAs you and you die and then the lane's over.
Right.
I think Alk's the hero.
Okay.
The last pick, Alk. No, nope. Trent, you called it.
All right. I was right the first time.
You just needed to believe in yourself.
Yeah. Well, the good thing about Lina is that she's this like crazy tower hitter now. It's disgusting. Mm-hmm. She's like just as good as Sniper, I feel like, once you have this Bloodstone up.
All right. So what do we think, guys? We'll restate the odds. 4.75 for Spirit, 1.15 for Virtus Pro coming into game one. Which draft do we favor?
Listen, let me tell you. That I told you earlier that if you don't put a game on Spirit, you've lost it. But I don't think this is the game. This is not the game that they win, I'm pretty sure.
Really?
I don't know. I mean, it's pretty good. I'm kind of interested to see how the one position solitaire works out if that's the case. You know, like, that's the thing that really I'm kind of the most interested about, because we haven't seen it in a while. And when I used to see it, like when Loda would play, it never really worked out the way that you wanted it to, kind of thing.
I definitely think VP could snowball this game. Spirit Breaker, Disruptor, Lina, like all heroes that can get out of control if they get a couple early kills.
Right.
VP has absolutely no late game, but they can just roll over Spirit because Bounty Hunter is not going to really do anything in the early game with all this aggression. I don't see them stopping it. VP, game one.
VP? I'll go Spirit. I think they'll get a little bit of an edge. I know. I can give them this game. I could see it working out with the Healing Ward, and they just rush everything with Shadow Fiend, and if it's all on the Blink Dagger for Shaker.
Alrighty, and with that
said... It's a support Shaker. Fuck!
With that said, we'll hand it over to our casters. We've got Annie and Brax here for game number one.
All right, thank you very much, panel. I'm Annie, being joined by the lovely Brax here for the Betway Arena Best of Five King of the Hill. Already going to be a very interesting matchup for game number one. What are your thoughts on the draft, Brax?
Very interesting to see the safe lane slaughter.
Yeah, that is going to be pretty interesting. How often do you run into that in your pubs?
Like, never. Actually, never.
So, I mean, how is he going to itemize differently than just your standard position four offlane? Obviously, he's going to get more money, but what does he do with it to make it impactful?
So he can either go for, like, the Fissure up top, blocking the Darkseer off. He's in trouble here.
Yeah, he is definitely just pacing back and forth, trying to make it down the stairs. The Blade Fury comes in. Crystal Maiden has the Frostbite ready, holding him in place. And I don't think he's going to get out alive. One more hit will secure first blood, and our support Shaker snaps up the money for that.
All right, so about the Slaughter, I think he'll probably go for like a Blink Shadowblade-style build. People used to go Armlet, sometimes Vanguard in the past, but I think that kind of playstyle is outdated. He'll look to like sit on the Shadow Fiend all game with the Shadowblade and Juggernaut, and that'll really help him like pick him off the entire game.
All right, we'll see how that's going to be working out with him. He's going to have a Disruptor there to help him out. Any other super unusual matchups? Looks like our mid lane is going to be Lina, no surprises there, versus our Shadow Fiend. Our panel was talking a little bit about that, but who do you think is going to come out on top of this matchup?
I think Lina definitely is favorable in this matchup by a lot, actually.
Ooh.
Lina, destroy Shadow Fiend. 1v1 and 2v2.
All right, definitely interested to see that. We've got aggressive cows on both sides in the mid lane here. Spirit Breaker with Earthshaker trying to keep things going. Obviously, Spirit Breaker wants to dip out of the mid lane and go explore the map a little bit eventually. Iceberg here, forced to eat up the Iron Branch tree just to keep himself healthy, taking a lot of harass in lane, like you mentioned.
Yeah, one bash and he was dead there, actually. This is a very scary lane for him.
Yeah, aside from techies, Lina, she got the auto attack length. Animation, pretty gosh darn slow, but of course with Spirit Breaker there, you got a little bit of backup. So, mid lane, looks like Radiant have a firm handle on that. Up top, we've got Pasha on our Darkseer, just running away from the Juggernaut, but I don't think there's going to be too much more blood there. I think that was a situational fissure. Now, here in the mid, things getting separated. Spirit Breaker in some unfriendly territory, but again, not really taking damage. Eats up two tower shots, but goes back to farming now. He can go ahead and just walk his way around the long way.
Yep, Phobos is coming in, the offlane bounty hunter here. Oh, this is pretty big, actually, on Lina.
Yep, they got the fissure there. One more raise, and she's dead. Iceberg picks up the money for that. 150 gold going his way, and now Lil running away from this Earthshaker. He doesn't have a fissure, fresh out of mana for that, and Bounty Hunter only level 1, so nothing he can toss out there.
Man, this experience change where it takes heroes longer to get level 2, really showing their Lina's so close to 2 in a normal game, or like last patch, she would have her stun already and probably be okay.
Sentry popped down in the mid for the Dire, just making sure the Radiant don't have any info on that, making sure that Bounty Hunter can creep in whenever he'd like to. And now here we go, charge in, they got him under the tower, but the fissure blocks him away. FNG keeping his buddy safe. Very high energy mid lane here going on. Meanwhile, DK Phobos, he's crawling around through the jungle, looking to snap up a bounty, and he'll find it.
Phobos' style of offlane is something we used to see years ago, back when the offlane used to be like impossible to lane. People would play offlane Bounty Hunter, get level 2, gank mid, and then they would just play around like some really large Shadow Fiend style hero. It's very different from what we're used to seeing nowadays.
Yep. Lina now fending for herself a little bit as Spirit Breaker takes a brief rest. Down bottom, I mean, this Core Slaughter, he's having all the space in the world as far as Core Slaughter games go. It's gonna be pretty easy for him to get the items he needs.
Yeah, I'm still not entirely sure what he's gonna build.
I mean, does he stick with the same, you know, straight blink and
into... charge on mid?
There we go. They got the Dragon Goodbye. Slave. They need one more hit though. Iceberg, he's running away fast. He's got the boots and Spearbreaker doesn't. They just can't catch up to him. Dragon Slave, no more mana for that, so they have to let him go with one hit left. He was so deliciously low. I think he was at like 5 HP. My goodness.
Yeah, something ridiculously low. He still had the Fairy Fire, so he was pretty confident he was okay. Good choice to go for boots, especially against the dual lane. Keeps him nice and safe.
Oh, here we go. They're getting their revenge. They'll take it out on FNG. He'll take one for the team there. Just stuck around a little bit too long. Soaked some alright experience. He's hit his level 3, but obviously not ideal there. Long range raise clips onto Noah. They've got the charge though. They're keeping him in place. Light strike array. There's no more mana. Another raise just to try to guesstimate, but they're going to glimpse him back and they lose the Shadow Fiend. Lil snaps up the money from that, so both mid laners playing a very, very dangerous game.
That's got to feel bad. No 10 HP going for the big play.
Oh, mid lane. Looks like Lil could be in some trouble again. FNG tries to dump some damage on him, and he's fresh out of regen. So he may have to go and play this one safe. Both shrines currently on cooldown on the Radiant side.
Very mid lane focused for both teams here.
Yeah. Our side laners getting pretty much whatever they need. Ramzes on the Slardar is really shaping up here. He's got himself the most last hits in the game by, you know, 10. He's doing a really nice job. Up top, though, our Darkseer could be in some trouble. Pasha trying to surge away, but he's in an unfriendly land. Phobos hanging around very closely.
Even Shadow Fiend rotating in here for this. Jesus.
Yeah, it's a lot of money just for a Darkseer. They're spending a lot of time trying to secure this, and looks like DK Phobos is actually chasing down the Disruptor here. Trying to rotate for different targets. There's a charge coming in onto FNG. Lightstrike Array clips on one, not going to hold him in the kinetic field. It looks like they're lacking damage to actually finish this one out. The charge continues onto FNG. They get the bash onto Vanskor as well. Another Lightstrike Array holds him down, but there's the Frostbite. Oh, Glimpse back will save the Lina temporarily. And Pasha, he's in the heart of the action with this Ion Shell. Try to chase down Vanskor. Vanskor getting low. That looks like Vanskor will fall. They trade for the Earthshaker. That's currently a 2-for-1, and now a charge back in onto the mid lane. Iceberg kind of took a nap there just momentarily, and I don't think they've got the damage to bring him down. He eats up the Fairy Fire. Lil now trapped in the trees versus 3 heroes, the Fissure, and they will collect the money. What a violent fight.
Is this normal? What's going on here? This is very CIS-style Dota here.
Absolutely.
We've got level 3 Shadow Fiends invading the jungle, trying to kill Darkseer. 4v4s in the mid lane, while Ramzes just free farms in the side lane. He's got his Midas now in Slardar.
I mean, the action's not stopping. You see Lil threatening out another charge there. This is just entirely mid lane focused. Meanwhile, Solo picking up some good XP, already level 3.5, and our Slardar down bottom. He's rocking his almost level 7. Up in this top lane, BZZ on the jug, almost level 7 as well. I mean, this is just cores doing whatever they want while the mid laners duke it out.
Yeah, Ramzes is going to be very, very farmed this game. Radiant's top tower is under attack. Extremely fast Midas, free lane, tower taken already too.
Yeah,
and we can really see the mid laners suffering and experience this game. Shadow Fiend's not even level 5 yet at 6.5 minutes.
Yeah, really difficult for him, and this Bounty Hunter has been pretty much free roaming. He's picked himself up 4.25. He's doing all right in terms of farm, switching over to net worth. He's, you know, where a Bounty Hunter should be without his level 6 yet.
So when do these guys get involved here? BZZ on the Juggernaut, Ramzes on his Slaughter. Because I'm sure he can kind of like tip the scales in these fights, right? They're both not really coming to the fights yet. They're both just farming the side lanes. Once Ramzes has like his blink or something, he's really gonna blow open the game. Or if BZZ manages to get like a nice TP rotation in with the Omni Slash.
I mean, I feel like BZZ's comfortable farming as long as they'll let him. I think Spirit have a little bit more late game presence, so as long as nothing's really going down. Speaking of going down here on this cliff on the Dire side, we do have FNG trying his best to deward. Now Lil comes forward. There is going to be a glimpse back. Vanskor taken out. And now they are going to be rotating in Ramzes as well as Solo. They've got 2 heroes in the kinetic field, but there's just no level 6 to finish him off. Dust comes out from Lil. He's still alive, and they've got Fission on Phobos, but he's juking through the trees the best he can. Looks like Lil thinking about a charge out. It's going to be ambitious. He's got to take his way through the mid lane, gets himself down to low ground, and he'll He'll circle back from there.
He's undercover.
Yeah, he's hiding his best. But what does he really do about this? I feel like he should just try to go home. This'll come in handy. Up in the top, Vanskor just eaten alive. My goodness. Went for the rune and punished. And Lil finally will make it back to his own shrine on this side of the map. So, Rady definitely getting a lot done in the last couple of minutes, but there's our first Omni Slash debuted. No hesitation there. BZZ lets it rip, and they are able to cancel this TP from Ramzes, and they've got him down. He's sprinting away from this Blade Fury, but Juggernaut sure is fast. He jukes out the crush, and now FNG going in, trying to get the body blocks. They will get the stun. The Fissure finally dishes the deadly blow.
All right, big kill. This game is quite the slugfest. It's hard to really see which team comes out on top of these ganks, but as you said before, Team Spirit, they definitely have the better late game here.
Yeah, I mean, as long as Juggernaut can sit back and, you know, be quiet for the first couple minutes of this game, he's scoring up a lot of net worth. He's feeling no real rush to go and push himself before he's ready. Mid lane here, our Disruptor could be in some trouble. Gonna get clipped on the wrong side of the Fissure, but doesn't even matter. There's a charge into DK of Phobos, but I don't really know if you can complete that. There's a lot of unfriendly heroes in the area.
Yeah, definitely. You know, Suns fan, big hater of the Shaker, but, you know, lots of presence from FNG this game already.
Yeah, definitely doing his job, puppy guarding up the mid lane and making an impact. I worry that Slardar, he's getting so much space for himself. You mentioned the full Midas, and now he's got 1,000 gold on top of that to work on his Blink or whatever his first real item's going to be.
Yeah, it looks like he's going for the treads first. He doesn't want to play like as a Blink initiator. You know, he wants to get tanky, get beefy, play like a real carry.
I mean, kind of super late game items are we going to see out of Slardar? Like, what does a really farmed six-sodded Slardar even have?
It's probably going to be like Blink, Shadow Blade, Heart, BKB, AC kind of style Slardar.
Nah, just the...
That's what I imagine, at least.
Don't even try to touch me, I'm too tanky kind of build.
Right.
Well, he's perhaps going to get initiated on here. They've got eyes on him now with this Dire Ward drop down. Three heroes grouped up. A little surprised. There's been so much action, so many rotations, but very little smoke used.
Yeah, I'm not sure where VP go next. It's like they don't have Blink on Slardar, you know. Disruptor, still no boots yet. Level 5. It's like they can't really... They need some time, you know. They need some alone time for their supports to kind of catch up, get their basic items, levels up, so they can actually... You know, make moves around the map, pressure the Juggernaut. Because right now, they actually can't kill this guy.
Yeah, looks like they're going to be allocating some resources. Lil swapping over to the top lane just to, I guess, keep eyes on him. And ooh, there they go. Lil could be in some trouble there. Fissure clips onto both. And Omni Slash just going to be gobbled up by the Spirit Breaker. And he's just going to eat it there. Suns fan may have his doubts about the Shaker, but you can't argue that he has just done a phenomenal job this game.
Yeah, he's definitely owning this game. Radiant's top tower is
under attack. Iceberg, our Shadow Fiend, looks like he's going in towards his Dragon Lance. Nothing too unusual there. I mean, do we just see a BKB after that? Standard stuff? Or maybe early
yeah,
Silver
definitely.
Edge?
BKB looks like it makes you immortal this game.
Alright, down bottom, Ramzes just continues to go to work completely untouched. He's just sitting back mid lane. Solo gonna get tracked up as our Bounty Hunter finally shows off his gorgeous level 6 and... Well, he could be in a little bit of trouble. Gonna get glimpsed back. Lina with the Dragon Slaves clips him up, and... Well, they do lose vision of him just in time. Can't finish him off with that Laguna Blade. Up top, BZZ looking to score first tower for himself. It will get denied. A little unfortunate for him, but he still does get a lot of space to go and farm wherever he wants.
Yeah, speaking of farm, Slardar, 2,100 gold. He is not going for treads yet as a quick buy, but he's probably going to buy the Blink Dagger pretty soon. And I feel like with Blink on VP, they can really open up the game here.
Charge here, FNG guarding this Haste Rune. Looks like Shadow Fiend's going to be coming in, but do they continue this charge? It looks like Lil makes it into the river. There is going to be a glimpse back. They catch out FNG, but he's not going to get stuck in that kinetic field, and they just have to let him go. Lil very patient, just waiting to go back up the stairs. It looks like our Lina is going to be going into her Bloodstone after the Arcane Boots. No surprise there with the talent that's the negative 30 second respawn. If you get the Bloodstone, you're just always alive.
Yeah, it's actually like an instant respawn for the majority of the game. ridiculous.
Do you think that needs to be changed, or is that one of the reasons why Lina's viable again?
It's so strange, right? Like, they gave all these supports gold per minute, XP, and respawn timer talents, but there's some of these that can be played as cores, right? And then once they do come out, it's like all these heroes respawn instantly. Smoke mid lane, Blink Dagger coming on the chicken right now. Or, sorry, Armlet, actually, the Slardar. Okay, no Blink Dagger.
Yeah, interesting choice there. So they still lack a little bit of initiation. They've really got to rely on smart charges and Lina placing well-timed light strike arrays. And now it looks like we're going to have a rumble in the mid as everyone getting in there. Solo just face-checking this area. They will catch out the Spirit Breaker. And oh, the Vac Wall into the Static Storm. This is a beautiful initiation from VP. They're going to claim a tower, and my goodness, that was just the wombo combo they needed.
Yep. No Blink Dagger required. When you've got Secret Agent Solo in the back lines, he just ran between the towers, got vision from the charge, ulted them. They had no idea he was coming.
That was really aggressive positioning from a core, let alone a disruptor.
Yeah, that was pretty cool to watch.
It looked like they weren't going to get what they needed into that Static Storm, but then the vacuum wall came through. This Darkseer was on point, rotating out of the top lane and really helping out his team in a big way. And looks like he's got a Blink queued up for himself. Nothing too surprising. Already has the mech arcanes. So definitely a well-farmed Darkseer here. Third on the net worth chart, surpassing his own Lina.
Yeah, going back to the respawn timer thing on heroes like Lina, I think this is one of the best talents in the game, the respawn timers. Especially for like offlane heroes, Beastmaster, Sand King, they all have respawn timer talents as well. Bounty Hunter is scouting this gank out on Lina, but I don't think they can actually get this. He's playing a bit too careful for this.
Yeah,
anyways, OP. That's what I think of the respawn timer talents.
All right. Good to hear it from a professional, because I played against Alina the other day, and she just didn't die. DK Phobos getting a good amount of vision here on the Radiant team, making sure they're not going to be coming
Soul
up.
Soul coming up from the back again.
Yeah, they're trying it again. They will go through. They do catch out Shadow Fiend into the Static Storm. He's going to be vacked in, pushed out, and they get the kill on him. His Requiem not going to be doing too much, but there's the Echo Slam. Currently, everyone's still alive, but getting low. No one tracked up, but still fighting. BZZ running for his life there. Phase Boots rolling, and, well, charge comes in. Can I actually catch up to him here? Dragonslave off the mark, and again from across the river, FNG is the hero with these fissures. Wow. From the Echo Slam to the fissure that saved the day, this guy is MVP in my book.
If he wins, he'll be my MVP.
Alright, good assessment, Prax.
I don't know if he'll win the game, though. This is looking pretty tough. Team Spirit, they can't really take fights. VP, this is like their time to shine right now. Their heroes are extremely tanky, extremely powerful. Solo, another flank. He was smoked in that fight. He came around the back, got the Static Storm and the Kinetic Field off on the Shadow Fiend. He died pretty much instantly without casting a spell. Iceberg actually went for Blink Dagger on Shadow Fiend. Interesting. Not a fan.
Are you more of the Shadow Blade Silver Edge type of guy?
Well, it's like, no, I think he should just be going straight for BKB. He like can't even get in a spot where he can use this item.
Oh, here we go. They got the glimpse at him. They're going to trap him in the kinetic field again, but he's going to blink away. This time Lil in a very unfriendly world. He's trying to go and buy himself some time to charge, but I don't know if we'll get that luxury there. A track kill going the way of the Dire on that one.
Yep, nice track kill for five heroes there. Pretty good.
You know, it's something. There we go, DK Phobos keeping the track sprayed out. Ramsey's going to be going, casting out the amp damage, but knows he better be walking away as the rest of the Dire are going to be chasing after him. Solo's there trying to zone, pops out the kinetic field, traps in FNG, but doesn't look like it'll be too much. And there we go, FNG with
he's
another gorgeous fissure, traps him back. The crush to bring himself back around. Vanskor still no ult at level 7, so Crystal Maiden doesn't have a whole ton of damage to contribute to the fight. It's really just BZZ sitting on that Omni Slash. A charge comes in. They know FNG's in the trees, but another fissure. They can't get on top of this guy. It's like Spirit Breaker thinking about reinitiating there. Crystal Maiden trapped Solo in the Static Storm. She will get bumped back into there by Lil. Meanwhile, Laguna Blade comes out, and they will finish off BZZ. Another charge to reinitiate. Ramsey's still alive with the help of that armlet. Kinetic Field to try to break up the fight. It will be a 1-for-2 exchange. And that's probably going to favor VP again. Lina's back up almost instantly.
Yeah, scrappy fights. Definitely favor heroes like Disruptor, where you can pick people off, you know, chase them down. Man, but if FNG ever does make it to Blink Dagger, it'll definitely be like a big fight changer. Well, we've got eyes on Lil here.
Oh, we've got all the Dire team rotating in. They sure would like to kill this Lina for 5 seconds again. And, well, they will be successful. That's Iceberg raking in more and more net worth for himself now at the top of the chart. Pretty handily, and this time he's going for the BKB.
Okay, so things are looking pretty good for Spirit, actually. They managed to salvage that awkward team fight, and now they can transition that one kill into a tower. Lina's back alive again. Who knew? Who saw that coming?
And this is before her Bloodstone really kicks in. She's got it now, 12 charges, but we're going to see insta-respawn Lina next time she goes down.
Yep.
Up top, Radiant looking to exert their pressure here on this tower. It's pretty low, should go down pretty easily, and just kind of keeping things even all across the map while Team Spirit make a go for mid lane.
I think once these towers fall, both teams are going to be looking at Roshan, Slaughter, Amplify damage, destroys Rosh, Shadow Fiend, Juggernaut, very high damage heroes against Rosh as well, along with the sustain from the healing ward. Charge on mid.
Nice.
Right, we'll keep in vision of him.
Yeah, he's just playing around, making sure he can get in there if he needs to. And now DK Phobos returning the favor. Just keeping everyone tracked up. I mean, these track kills are starting to have a pretty solid impact. As soon as you can catch out one person, just get a little more money. Definitely bumping up the net worth of the Shadow Fiend, the one to usually actually collect the kill. There we go. Crush up. They've got eyes onto DK Phobos, and he's not going to be living through that one. So playing a little cocky on the Radiant side of the map, and that will catch up to him as he's under Ascent reward.
Yeah, but don't worry, guys. Space created. I found them all. Yep. Have you ever seen the Bounty Hunter eggs?
With the bouncing thing that just keeps going round and round?
Yeah, I think it hits everything twice and it mini-stuns for like 0.75 seconds each hit. It's actually insane.
I've seen it built. I don't think I've seen it win games.
Okay. Well, if he gets to it, he might win this game. It's pretty good.
Yeah, especially now Radiant really grouping up all together, very small wad. It's easy to go in, get that Blink Echo Slam, get that toss bouncing around. And well, it looks like Dire really keen on taking Rosh like he called out.
Speaking of Blink Echo, he's only 200 gold away from it.
Yeah, it'd be a dangerous time for him to go down now, but it looks like they do need to fight. Lightstrike Array holds back the bounty into the pit temporarily. Requiem popped out, doing a little bit of spray damage, but not really collecting anyone isolated there. Now Lil in a little bit of trouble. But there's the Vac wall back in. They've got everyone trapped in that kinetic field. Vanskor going to be dancing, and Pasha's in some trouble. We'll be able to surge to freedom, and Iceberg just barely alive after all is said and done. He's going to get glimpsed back, but
oh,
missed
my God.
By the Dragon Slave. BZZ will be able to take out the Disruptor. Ramzi's under the shrine, still in a lot of danger. He's going to be tracked up, but blinking away, he'll still have vision of him. They won't
How
be able
did they
to
survive
chase.
That combo?
They're tanky, man.
I guess that healing ward must have been doing work in that fight.
Yeah.
Shadow Fiend lives there with 50 health.
Yeah, I thought the Dragon Slave was going to get him when they glimpsed him back, but just the smallest amount of mistiming.
Yeah, it was so close. Well, another good fight for Team Spirit.
Is this enough for Team Spirit to make their way into the pit, or is Radiant still going to be way on top of this?
No, they definitely can't make their way into the pit, not just yet. With Blink Dagger on Shaker, they might be able to make a nice pickoff or something. But if it is on Lina, then she's going to come back instantly, so might want someone else.
Yeah, FNG did commit his Echo Slam in that fight, so he can't just go Blink Echo and score the points here. Still has to wait a minute and a half.
They'll definitely need some pretty big pickoff here. It's still early into the game. Heroes aren't that high level. Respawn timers are pretty quick. And they don't actually have the highest Roshan damage. They have good sustain in the pit, but that's about it. SF is good. Jug is good, but Roshan is still a tanky monster.
Man, after all the back and forth fighting, oh my, there we go. Vacuum into a double man crush. The Lightstriker Ray clips as well. The Death Requiem does a little bit of damage, but not enough. DK Phobos, oh, he's still alive, and they will be able to score. My goodness, all the Radiant lived through that. Spiritbreaker finally drops way over here in the trees. They get the glimpse back onto the Juggernaut. Slardar comes back in to crush with what could have been his last breath. He's tracked up. It's dangerous, but they will find what they want. Two very important kills. Pasha now pacing back and forth, trapped behind a fissure, but still alive as well. Finally, the Nova from Crystal Maiden takes him down, but what a very bloody fight.
Yeah, it's just back and forth all the time. They got the fantastic initiation there with the vacuum crush into the Lina stun. Man, it's hard to survive that on Shadow Fiend, even with his BKB, unless he can, like, has someone else to stand on the front first, so he can get his Blink Dagger and BKB off, then it's really difficult for him to survive. You know, even with the Fissure coming through, it doesn't really matter. He's just chain stunned forever.
Yeah, pretty much. That's what it feels like. It feels like no one could move in these fights with the, you know, the bashes from Spirit Breaker, the Fissures from Earthshaker. Everyone's just kind of sitting around waiting to slosh out their next go of damage.
Actually, no one's on Lina. And he just picked up his Shadow Blade, so that's going to help a lot in these team fights. He got his plus 50 damage talent, level 15 as well. He's quite strong right now.
I'd say so. Yeah, looking at overall levels, we'll see who's hitting some milestones. It looks like, my key bindings. Yeah, Lina and Shadow Fiend still a fair ways away from level 20. Darkseer about to hit his 15. There we go. Initiation onto DK Phobos once again. Just getting a little cocky. The vacuum onto everyone there. Requiem let loose by the Shadow Fiend. He's rocking his BKB. Ramzi's somehow still alive, relying on his armlet to keep him up. And there we go, BZZ. Trapped in, trying to crawl back around the trees, and will bite the dust. And there we go, Lightstrike Array onto the Earthshaker as well. Shadow Fiend, the only survivor from Team Spirit, now as good a time as any to hop into the pit for Virtus Pro. Pasha doesn't want to give up the chase.
For the glimpse on this.
Yeah, they're going in. They've got Vision with the charge. They're going to be bringing him back in. Oh my, what a wonderful play. They get him down. Ramzi's picks up the money for that, so he's getting very close to his own BKB. Of course, with quick respawn times, it's still risky to do this, but you gotta try with the Corrosive Haze and the Slardar. You're still putting out a lot of damage. Was that just a Laguna Blade to break the Lincolns on a
rush?
That
was. Sometimes, you know, you just gotta do it.
I heard it. I heard the sound, and I'm like, no, she's definitely just taking creep somewhere, but nope. Lincoln's broken, H is secured, so I can't doubt that.
Yep, so Lina almost has Boots of Travel. She's gonna have, like, 3 lives. Instant respawn after she dies, so she can boots of travel back into the fight too, even after she loses her Aegis. VP looking quite good right now. They're taking fights very well with the vacuum, static storm, all the AoE combos looking really nice.
Alright, Brax, we gotta do some math here.
Okay.
So, when you die with the Aegis, it's a 5-second respawn, right?
Right.
If she dies with the Bloodstone and the respawn talent and TP's back into a fight, is that quicker?
Yes, it is actually.
All right. Well, either way, Pasha is in a world of hurt here. At least isolates 3 heroes now trapped in the trees.
And man, FNG's he's got this blink and everything, but it's still so hard for him to get his spells off. You know, solo drops the static storm right over the top of the heroes. In the last fight there, he could have got the echo on too, but he blinked right into the static storm.
Mhm.
Just very difficult for him to position in these fights.
I mean, Solo's been doing a phenomenal job, as well as with the Darkseer. The vacuums to pull everyone into the static storm if there's a slight miss is so useful.
Yep. VP set up here in the trees waiting for these guys to push forward. Looks like it won't happen, though.
Yes, Sayori, he does have a BKB. Thank you. Slardar, ready to debut
that. Nice guy, Sayori.
Yeah, no, he's helping us out.
So this game has kind of gotten to like an awkward pace, right? It's very clear that Spirit have the superior late game, but VP, they're getting these fantastic initiations off. Spirit Breaker Charge gives them vision. Just, you know, these vacuum crushes into Static Storm, Lina Stun combos are doing work.
Radiant definitely getting aggressive, now crossing over to the Dire side of the map. They want to debut that new Slardar Blink BKB. I mean, he's been pretty immortal in these fights, only having one death to his name after all is said and done. So, definitely eager to stay in there and be more frontliney, because he has had to go in and kind of crush and then immediately back off to stay alive, and now he can probably weather the storm a little better.
Yeah, he hits very hard in these fights.
Smoke up from Team Spirit.
Team Spirit smoked up as well. This is pretty good for them. They can make sure that their initiations, you know, are clean. They're not spotted when they go in, so they can actually get their spells off well. But it's just so difficult because Team Spirit, you know, they don't have to be, like, sitting here together. They have, like, Spirit Breaker, Slaughter heroes that can get there quickly. All they have to do is cover each other, not group up.
Lina easily able to melt down that tower. I mean, it seems like now more than ever, she's just a super strong tower hitter. 19 charges on her Bloodstone, hasn't been picked off since she grabbed that up. Aegis still online for her, so she is really on top of the world. She's got a BKB of her own queued up. What does she go for after that? How does Lina become, you know, the right-clicking hero?
She'll probably go into, like, Shiva's. Just a tanky right-click build. She just wants to survive, like, the Omni Slash and all these spells, and then she'll be able to keep casting as many spells as possible. But man, they're really turning every hero into sniper nowadays. Lina's got a plus 150 attack range talent.
Oh my god.
Who's next?
She can just stand from like her tier 3s and hit onto the tier 1s. She is very far away.
She outranges towers now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Alright, so that's a bold play. Not expecting everyone to be there. Her Aegis is going to be popped. Has to wait a grueling 5 more seconds till she respawns.
Yep, Team Spirit need to get out.
Yeah, they're going to be glimpsed back in. They're going to find at least one. He's going to immediately pop the Echo Slam, and everyone else still wants to fight this, but it's getting dangerous now. Ramsey's picking up a couple kills for himself. Lina does go down again, but again, instantly back because of her Bloodstone, and she can TP right back into this fight. They're going to get more. Crystal Maiden getting very, very low. They ignore the Crystal Maiden, who's going to be walking to freedom. Going to meet her inside the pit there. Crystal Maiden gets out completely fine, but they're going to go for bigger, juicier targets. Laguna Blade dumped down onto BZZ, and they will find the Bounty Hunter as well. They've got the Vision. He's under a sentry, and he is out of there. There they go. No one pops the Aegis. Has to use up a couple of those Bloodstone charges, but getting back into the fight quick enough to make a huge impact definitely salvage that for them, and they're going to go straight tier 3s here. There's nothing to stop them. Only Crystal Maiden left alive. Earthshaker already committed the Echo Slam in that first fight, so doesn't have anything to defend here.
Yeah, just unfortunate that Team Spirit happened to find Lina there. If it was another hero like Slaughter or something, they could definitely pop him from full health.
Oh man, Ramsey's just going all the way in here. Maybe a little bit of hubris there from that BKB pickup, but the charge forward from Lil. They want to get this done. They want to at least zone them back. FNG, though, starts to take out that aggression. Vacuum into the kinetic field. They trap in one. Is that enough to make this a secured game? Oh, man. They get Crystal Maiden as well. This time, she doesn't live through it. FNG trapped in the trees. Laguna bladed down. It's looking grim here. Buybacks are few and far between, and VP starting to rip apart these tier 3s in the racks. They're going back in. That's an ultra kill, and the GG called out as they're looking for a rampage. Come on, man, get it.
Please steal this.
Yay!
Ugh.
All right, well, GG to Furtus Pro in game number one of this best of five. Definitely a lot of action-packed matches left to go, but, man, VP rotated as a group there. So much synergy.
Yeah, VP looking good. Team Spirit definitely looked pretty good in the early game, dealing with the quad lane pretty much mid. Yeah, and the MVP take it.
All right, so that's going to do it for us for game number one of the Betway Arena Best of Five King of the Hill. Let's kick it back to our panel for some more expertise.